Right.
Hi.
What are you eating?
Mangoes.
Yeah? Are they tasty?
Yep, they're frozen.
They're frozen. Mmm.
Just what you should eat in front of a very toasty fire.
Right, which is in surrounding a very, very cold day out front.
You're sticky.
Mm. So are you getting cold yet? No? That's good.
Isn't I'm using more cold because that's even more than cold.
Exactly, huh? And since you have no thermal mass, this is really saying something. So, ha!
Yep.
Two frozen raspberries and you're kind of chilled off in the summer. So, nice.
Did you want to do a video of me pulling the food out?
What, honey?
On Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
Is the video still on?
Yes, it's still on Christmas.
On Christmas, my dad's and my sister's birthday are on Christmas Eve.
Mm-hmm.
Both birthdays are on the same birthday.
Really?
What?
Fun.
Yours and his.
So we're gonna go to mom.
First.
What do we got? What have we? Ooh, we got a pork roast. Mmm.
Lamb
roast. Oh, even better.
I've seen it. Nice.
Carrots, buds, squash.
Yeah.
Lightly seasoned.
Ready.
Okay.
Yep. 28.
So, dirt patch. How long have you had it in? And it's now 6:30, so 3 hours.
The fire went out.
Hmm.
Almost, not quite. I mean, it wasn't.
Definitely going
the way that you know that you're. I would not cook in the wood stove without the lid on. If you don't have the lid on, it never gets to temperature.
Mm-hmm.
So it has to be covered. Yeah, I don't think this one's done yet.
Okay. Probably another hour out.
Yeah.
That's good. Well, the stove is definitely putting off some heat. Wow. So, I just got home and came upstairs, and instantly I got that toasty warmness we were feeling.
And as
about.
You can see, the damper at the top is closed, allow
closed.
It to circulate around the oven.
Yeah. And those two, both bottom and top, are wide open. So it's getting plenty of air to circulate. And, in fact, where's my heat gun? Here. Wait and talk, and I'll be right back.
If my fire hadn't gone out at 4:30, it would be done by now, but again, I wasn't paying attention. The house was still warm, so it didn't occur to me that maybe the stove wasn't still going. It's because I closed the bottom and I closed the top all the way down. I have it open an inch and a half right now, where previously I had it shut all the way.
So we're 613 degrees, somewhere around the hot
catching
back.
It. Nope.
Well, it's going to go out now.
I'm trying to turn it so they can see the number.
700 degrees. Let's
Hold
see
on.
If it'll...
There,
there
you
we go.
Go.
681. Towards the back. We scan. 666. That should be interesting. So it drops down to about 500 by the front. And then the medium panel sits between 300 to about 500 here. So, something to understand, it's as hot here as it is back here. So
yeah.
This is your hottest, and then medium hot, basically. And then you have this kind of shallow area of medium, and then it really drops fast as you get over to here.
Right.
So it's kind of like a warm oven right
and
there.
And you never need it to be that hot. It is really stoked up, because I'm trying to get it to heat back up so we can cook our dinner.
Yeah.
It really only needed to be coals in there, as long as there was some coals and some heat going on, but I shut it down. It didn't have enough oxygen. Anything else?
No, other than it really is. It's surface of the sun hot.
So at this point, we have windows open.
So anything in here would definitely be cooking.
200. It would probably be about 200 in there, wouldn't it?
170.
Yeah.
180. 160. 170. Yeah. It's cooking the temperature.
And the reason we don't have a water reservoir on this is that I did not want a water reservoir. When I was growing up, we had a Pioneer Made cook stove, and we had a water reservoir on it. And the only thing you could have really used it for was washing dishes or washing the floor, because the water inside would get a little tiny bit rusty.
Tasty.
Rusty. And, well, never wanted to...
Yeah, it would develop a taste of nastiness.
Yeah, it wasn't meant for bodily consumption. It was, internal consumption. It was meant as washing water. please stop coughing on purpose. That's not good for your lungs. Thank you. So if you're going to do drinking water on the stove, do it in a teapot. It doesn't take that long to heat water up on the stove.
We could load up our 5-gallon pot and have it done in, 2 hours. It would be probably close to boiling.
I don't think it would take that long. I think it would take 45 minutes, definitely. If it was this hot, it would take 45 minutes. If you had a cooler stove, it would take about an hour and a half. It takes a while for a teapot to boil. I don't know why, because it just feels so stinking hot when you're doing it. You'd think it would boil quicker. But on a wood stove, everything takes a lot longer. Who knows? I don't know why. Anyway, anything else?
Cleaning's longer.
Well, I don't mind the cleaning.
Cooking's longer.
The cooking is longer. You have to think.
Longer.
Yeah. You have to think ahead. Everything you do. Everything with the wood cook stove just is, it's like cooking from scratch. You have to think ahead by 2 hours. If you're going to be cooking with it, you need to be thinking about what temperature you want it at 2 hours before you put things in. Because then your coals can get nice and hot, and that'll hold your temperature evenly instead of a big hot fire like what we've got going now. And I mean, it's doing fine. It has some coals in there, but it's definitely warmer than it needs to be. Just have to babysit it. Is that it?
So we're going to try and fit a really big log in here. Hey, little one, you want to hold that camera?
I want to.
Hold it on the fire. That's Kaya. Say hi, Kaya.
Hi, Kaya.
Hey, you're fine. And, okay. Oh, shoot. Now that I got that open, I don't know how to get it closed. Oh, wait a second. Okay. Here, honey. Don't play. So,
nice,
pretty glow. It's all the infrared. That's what's messing with the camera. That's cool.
What? Infrared?
Yep,
what's
infrared.
Infrared.
Yeah, it's hot. Okay, so, two little logs.
What is infrared?
Well, let's see. So, there's my fist. And there's the side of the log for reference. That doesn't really help, does it? Anyway, okay, so throw two more logs in.
And kindling.
No kindling. Okay, it's gonna stay hot for a while. I should burn for another 2 hours. Honey, when did you put in the last log? Like 3 hours ago? 2 hours?
An hour? Purple!
So burning this hot is definitely.
What makes it purple?
Anyway, so you can hear that all the fans are on, trying to move the, keeping us from getting sweaty.
Okay. I'm sweating.
Yes, we are sweating. So, it's all right. Hey. We're gonna have a roast. So, anyway. So, thanks for watching. Oh, well, we'll see how fast the fire kicked off. Okay, burning those logs. Woof. Yeah, it's hot in there. Fire. Come down. Show it here. Right there. In the center, and then show it there. There you go. So, those logs are almost all burned back into embers themselves, so it's gotten really hot. Move up here, show the full damper. Okay, so the damper is all the way closed, and I closed down one of the two air intakes over there, too. Okay, now back where you were, honey, because I'm going to pull the roast out. Good. Okay. Ready? Keep the camera on where the motion is. Always. Get it. Oh, it's smelling like a good roast now.
Oh, okay. It's hot, huh?
It's actually getting through the glove. It's really hot. Okay. Wait. Bring it down. See if you can see how hot the oven is right now. No? Okay.
And it's hot.
Yep, it is. Nope. Let's see. Well, okay, I'm going to hit. Yep, the fat has dwindled down a little bit. It's definitely done now. All the squash is cooked. Carrots are probably still a little crisp, but she's good to go. Good job, Mom. So, veggies are done perfectly. Just a tiny little crisp in the thickest of the carrots, which is just amazing.
And the way you can tell when you're baking that something is done, at least when you need to really check on it, is when it starts to smell like it's done. If it doesn't smell like food yet, yeah. If it doesn't smell like food yet, then it's probably not done.
Look at that. Wow. I'm gonna slide in and get some of the fat layers.
Yummy, yummy, yummy.
The first thing that our girls eat when we have lamb or chicken or anything else, they always eat the fat first. Not so much in the store-bought stuff. They can definitely get their fill in the store-bought stuff. But ours that we raise, it's the first thing that they eat.
This is making my mouth water. Can I eat it right now?
That's a perfect.
This is just making my mouth water so bad.
Because we were a little late tonight, huh?
Yeah.
And Paige, she's the one that got the table set and got the salad ready.
Yeah, here's the salad. And the salad dressing.
What squash?
Me! Not me.
A little bit.
Yeah, a little bit for you.
That's not a little bit.
It's a little bit, because look at what Paige
did. Do I need to take the bottle away so that you'll eat your dinner?
I think so.
Put it down and eat your dinner, and then you can have your bottle, okay?
Got a big bit, right, Paige?
Yeah, I
so
am.
Done. You need to put it done. Okay. I can kill it.
Mom.